What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Miss T-Talk, and I'm here with Tina. How
are you? Hey, I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Yeah, it's great. Great morning.
Oh, yes.
Great evening.
Yes.
Good evening.
Yes.
It's like winding down.
Exactly,
yeah.
Rainy day.
Exactly. Rainy day, but it's going to get better for sure.
Yes. You had a long journey growing up.
Exactly, yeah.
You have to bring me back to the beginning. Mm-hmm. How was it growing up?
Growing up, you know, it was a journey, just like you said. For those who don't know, my name is Tina Mobley, and I have cystic fibrosis. I was actually misdiagnosed when I was little. At 21 months old, I was actually adopted. So I don't know who my real parents are, but I'm blessed to say that I have the parents that I have now. So basically, so this whole time, I was told that I had asthma. And so 9 or 10 years old, I was actually playing basketball outside, and I felt really sick. So my parents were like, you know, maybe it's just like a cold, or, you know, get some rest. You know, the typical way to, you know, get some rest and stuff like that. So my mom, you know, she kept a huge watch on me, and then she knew something was really wrong. Like, I felt like, literally felt like I was gonna die. So I was at the age of 9 or 10, and my mom, she was like, you know, telling my dad, you know, this is serious. I said, go to the hospital. So I went to the hospital, and they couldn't find out where we were wrong. So that was really scary. I was very young, and I just knew that I just wanted to get better. I don't know how or what you guys need to do to get better. Yeah.
In being misdiagnosed at such a young age.
Exactly. Exactly. So after a couple of tests, they found out that I had cystic fibrosis. It's not very common in African American people, so that was, I don't know if there was like a miscommunication with that. It's more common in Caucasian Americans. It's a very rare illness. For those who don't know, cystic fibrosis, it's a life-threatening illness. Statistically, they say that the life expectancy is 37 years old. So yeah, but I believe that we'll live past that.
Like,
definitely. Super definitely have like a positive aspect on that. Right now, currently, I'm just really raising awareness for it. There's 30,000 people in the United States that's living with cystic fibrosis, 70,000 worldwide, and 1,000. Yeah.
That's not a lot.
Exactly.
Because you have like 7 billion people.
Exactly.
So what's the percentage of people that have cystic fibrosis?
I'm not really sure the percentage now wise, but I just know that there's like 1,000 cases diagnosed each year. So, and you know, people do get misdiagnosed with cystic fibrosis, so it's good to really, you know, see the doctor and be on top of your stuff. So you never know what you have. Any symptoms, go to the doctor, and that's for anything. Like, just really taking care of yourself, keeping up with those doctor's appointments, because you never know.
Yeah, that's very important.
Exactly. My brother, this whole time, he didn't know he had leukemia. He was actually diagnosed October of last year. Yeah, we found out he had leukemia. So, and it happened because he just went on a regular doctor's checkup, and they were saying, like, you know, you haven't had a blood test in so long. So he got his blood test done, and that's how they found out he had.
He didn't know.
But he just, you know, after a while, you know, he was, you know, bleeding and stuff like that. So they found out later on. It was just like, yo, if he never got a checkup from the doctor, then we would have. You know, you never know what could have happened.
I'm glad that you're going to go to
the doctor. Yeah, go to the doctor, definitely. And as far as the CF community, what I'm trying to bring to them, I started my movement, Redefine the Life of Cystic Fibrosis, in 2016 in school.
Yes, at LIU Brooklyn.
Yes. I didn't know exactly you know, what I wanted to do in life, but I knew that, you know, I wanted to raise awareness for this illness. A lot of people don't know what it is, the things that we have to go through. A lot of people see me, they, you know, think, oh, she's healthy, stuff like that, she's on track. But no, cystic fibrosis, it's an invisible illness, so that's what people say.
It affects you.
Yes. So it affects your lungs, your digestive system. The building up of thick, sticky mucus in your organs, pancreas, and other parts of your body. So it gives us trouble breathing and stuff like that. Being that I did track, that helped, you know, really helped make my heart stronger and my lungs stronger as well.
That's great. I mean, you was a track star.
Yeah. Yes, and I my main event was long jump. So my furthest jump is 19 feet 6 inches. Yeah, and I did that at Monroe College.
Are you serious?
Coming out of high school, I was one of the top jumpers. I didn't reach my goal of 20 feet, but you know, that's okay. I was happy and blessed that I was able to even make it to 19 feet 6 inches. I also, you know, did the 4x1, 4x4, and 100, 200,
400. Have you ever done
the Olympics? No. I mean, I have, but track, you know, that, I mean, I still run here and there.
Yeah.
But, you know, I got a little tired of it, but I'm not, I didn't get tired of running because, you know, that's what's keeping me alive, especially with the illness, so.
Wow, that's, I like that you're making your heart stronger.
Yeah.
And you're raising awareness. I mean, you're going to these colleges, letting people know.
Yeah.
And you being an African-American woman, saying like, we do get it.
Exactly,
you know?
Yeah.
Some people don't know, and you're raising awareness to everybody.
Yeah.
These kids.
Mm-hmm.
Even growing up, because you found out pretty late.
Yeah, I found out really late. And I almost lost my life, like, around that time. Like, I was in a hospital to the point where the hospital became my home, so it was really, yeah, it was very tragic, and my mom, you know, she was crying, my dad was crying, my dad hardly cried, so, yeah, so I'm really going to bring that positive aspect to cystic fibrosis, you know, living with it, you know, it's nothing to be happy about, but, you know, and we do have a short life expectancy, but, you know, why not, you know, live up to our expectations, don't limit yourself just because of the illness.
That's the limit.
Yeah, just live, and that's what I've been doing. You know, I'm not letting this illness define me. I'm going out to events. I'm in PR, marketing, entertainment, media. So I do a lot of different things.
You do a lot of different things.
Yeah, exactly.
Come on.
Yeah, so.
You're really living your life to the fullest. And I like that you put your head into a lot of different things. I mean, tell me more about the entertainment and media that you do.
Yeah, so currently right now I work at CBS Sports Network. I'm a senior assistant. I've been there for a year and a month. Yeah, and I love it a lot. I never saw myself within media, but you know, I worked on a couple of things like during school in school. So at first, one of my first things that I did, I was working with the Brooklyn Nets scout and his youth program. And there, what I was doing there was I was the marketing director and his assistant as well. So I was working with them, and I actually so I collaborated with him, and that's where it all started. I collaborated with him with his shoot-a-thon. It was his first annual shoot-a-thon, and he let me, you know, speak to you know, the parents about cystic fibrosis, raising awareness. So that's where it all started. And then he also raised money for his youth program as well. So, you know, that was a huge blessing, and I'm happy, Khalid Green, that he let me do so. And then after that, I was invited to be a guest speaker at Adelphi University.
That
was the 65 Rose Gala. So, catch this. So, it's the 65 Rose Gala. So, 65 roses, 65 is like the number for cystic fibrosis. Because, like, there's a little story behind it. So, there is these two little boys, I don't remember their names, and, you know, he was telling his mother, like, I know what you work for. And she's like, what? Because you work for the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation. And then he was like, 65 roses. You know, like, some kids, they can't really pronounce
it. Pronounce
anything.
That,
because
I could. I'm like,
help me here. Yeah, so they said 65 roses. And she's like, oh my gosh, like, that's genius. Why not just make that a thing? So 65 roses, there's a 65 rose gala. And invited to be a guest speaker there, and we raised over $6,500 in donation for the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation. I never seen myself as a public speaker, but I'm blessed that was able to happen as well. I'm happy that they're inviting me to go there, so that tripled the amount that they made the previous year. And that was in 2017, yeah. So from there, I was like, I have to make this thing take off. I have to raise as much of
it. It gave that motivation.
It really did. And I'm just me, like, when I was doing track at the time, I posted videos of me jumping and stuff. And a lot of people reached out to me. And I was very overwhelmed about it. I was just like.
Even the foundation reached out to you,
so. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they did too. So the Boomer Science Foundation.
Mm-hmm.
They featured me on their website last year for September, the athlete of the month. I just did a podcast with them in May. I literally that day, like, I flew back from Vegas for my sister's birthday, and like only got 2 hours of sleep, and then they recorded it. They did a day with Tina, so that was huge. So that will be coming out soon, and I'll be featured in my first book publication December, January.
Oh my god!
That happened all within like a year, and like that's another thing. Like you never know what could happen, and this is just me, you know, just trying to help other people. So you never know what really happened, like what can happen. So whatever, like if you guys have a dream, go for it. Don't limit yourself. Not even with the illness, just don't limit yourself.
Tina,
it was
so great having you on my show.
Nice speaking to you, Tina.
I know. I'm so excited for what you have in the future. And you have a great, great future.
Thank you so much.
I'm there. I'm gonna watch your whole journey.
Oh my god.
Thank you.